As I went, I was told that I will be met at the Washington train station by Manley, whom I have already mentioned, who worked in Los Alamos and who was also the secretary of the General Advisory Committee that gave scientific advice to the administrators in charge of atomic energy. And John had one purpose. You're on your way to the senator, to Senator McBain. Don't go. There is a unanimous opinion among those of us who know about the hydrogen bomb. We must not work on it. Don't break the unanimity. I did not know what to say. I remember I said to him, all right, I won't go. I will call up the senator's office and tell him precisely what you told me. At that point, Manley said, then you better go. Let me say one thing. I did work on the hydrogen bomb. I did work on the original proposal of preventing equilibrium. I did work on boosters. I did work on alarm clocks. I was going to work on other things. None of these ideas were particularly difficult to produce. Practically all of them were independently developed in the Soviet Union. I claim that I made one contribution that really counted, and that was not in science. I made contributions there, but had I not made them, others would have. It did not make a great deal of difference, but the hydrogen bomb was very strictly secret, top secret. The number of people who were allowed to know about it were few. Most of those did not know the details. And those who had the other information, again, the majority, had no access in Washington. Among the people who had the full knowledge and had access, I was the only one who really made strong and clear arguments for the hydrogen bomb. In this sense, what Manley told me has to be understood. I did break the unanimity of the scientists, and had I not done so, it well may have happened that our work would never have started again. It well may have developed in such a way that the Soviet Union would have gotten far ahead of us in developing nuclear explosives. I don't want to say more about it. I have been attacked for the very point of advocating strongly the hydrogen bomb. Even recently, I have been asked, aren't you sorry that you did so? And to that question, I have a simple answer. I'm not sorry. To the extent that one can say the opposite, I do say so. I had to work on it, and I'm glad I did.